What's up, love doves? Nestled in the barbarian lair. I think it's a Tuesday. No, is it? It's a day. It's a day, and it's the afternoon, and it's hot as motherfuck in South Phoenix. Thank God I have my blessed AC unit. Phew. And coming at you, I'm a overwhelmed kitten right now. Overwhelmed, but I'm feeling really good. Happy to be here. Thank you for sharing headspace with me. I just wanted to touch on this idea that I had that basically I'll cut right to the chase. So I'm watching the Olympics, and the Olympics are interesting, right? I know some people hate, and I get it. I get it. Trust me. There's reasons to hate the Olympics. But like, it's interesting to see nations compete like that. Like, it's the sports aspect of it, and it's at such a high level. It's interesting. Like, it's charismatic. Like, you just have to, you're like, wow, dude. I saw these guys rowing. I saw a rowing competition today, and I forget who it was. I don't even remember the nations. I'm sorry, nations that were competing, but I don't remember, because I only ever watch television when I'm at the gym, when I'm at the stair climber getting those endorphins. But these guys were like the most amazing, like elegant, powerful rowers that I didn't even realize that rowing could be like that. And I'm just like, wow, how do you row that well? It's amazing. It's inspiring, honestly. And so I kind of understand it too. And this is a whole thing that's happening with me right now, where I'm like understanding things more. And why am I annoyed? Because this is gonna piss off all my socialist friends, but I understand the logic of capitalism now. God damn it! I understand the logic, but the thing is that there's a difference between predatory and true. So that's the thing. So I'm not trying to say anything about anything. I'm still feeling like isms make schisms over here, personally. But I get the logic of like competing to get better at something, because it utilizes our like selfish drive, and the selfish drive is, as we all know, very powerful. People want what they want, and they want it hard. And so what capitalism can do in a non-predatory aspect is it can inspire competition to get better at things that we all need. So for example, let's say the need that humans have to, as my dad would always do, he would vibe out. Now what is vibing out? Vibing out is, well, my interpretation of it or whatever. People like to have altered states of consciousness and then they like to relax. So my dad would like to have a gin martini on the rocks and he would like to listen to Wagner. My dad vibed out hard on gin martinis and Wagner. Other people like to vibe out in other ways. There's like infinite possibilities for ways to vibe out, the altered state of consciousness and the relaxation. This is because when you have altered states of consciousness and relaxation, you create sacred space. And then when sacred space gets created, then people can have epiphanies, and then hopefully we can get better at life. So humans like to vibe out. And so there you have the desire to smoke weed. So humans love to smoke weed to vibe out. Ideally, to vibe out and relax and have epiphanies, you know, but also just to relax or unwind or whatever. It's something humans need. Humans need the ganja. So when capitalism came to ganja, a lot of people were really like freaked out and afraid, including myself. I thought that it was, and I'm not also trying to say that it's perfect or anything, because I know people are going to get very upset with me right now and be like, but this, then this, and this, and this happened, and you don't understand how it's fucking everything up. And you're right, I don't. I don't understand all that. So I'm just giving you my perspective from my perspective over here. And the deals that I get at dispos are like off the chain sometimes. The deals I get at dispos now are completely off the chain. And it's a lot easier. Like, I don't have to, you know, you don't have to like drive around and meet people and stuff and have things be all shady. You just like go to the dispo and then you get fire deals on product that is like insane. Like it's almost too strong. And actually, I think there's something to that. Like I was visiting with a friend the other day, and he was saying that like ER doctors are having a lot of troubles with young people who they go to the ER because they had an edible and they have like a breakdown kind of, and that's like scary, you know? So, and that's where we have to negotiate things and stuff, right? Like, it's not just like get better and 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 better, because there needs to be like, oh man, these are getting all confused. Anyways, for me personally, it's been great when it's been helpful when capitalism came to marijuana, because it's just easier and more relaxed, and now people are making money and having resources and hopefully being able to take care of families, and everything's all good. So it's just kind of an interesting case study, I would say. And it even goes deeper than that, because you could argue that it's the spirit of the marijuana plant itself, because plants are intelligent. So you could argue that it's the spirit of the plant itself that is sort of introducing its consciousness to humanity through its growth. I don't know, possibly. Because I feel like that's how adaptogens work a lot of the time, is you take a bunch of adaptogens, like I like, let's say, reishi mushrooms. So reishi mushrooms are really good at surviving. So then when I take the reishi mushrooms, I feel like they make me good at surviving. They make me better at surviving. They like help me out. It's mystery. It's mysterious. The universe is mysterious. I don't know how everything works, but yeah, it's just interesting. Okay, so very long-winded way, because I'm an overwhelmed kitten right now. I'm a little bit tired. To getting to the point of the tidbit for today, which I was watching the Olympics, I was having thoughts, and I was thinking, like, you know how I believe that war should be ritualized so that innocent civilians are not slaughtered, because that's horrible and it makes everybody very sad. Anyone who has like two brain cells to rub together and then also a heart that's like functioning properly, it makes you sad when innocent civilians are slaughtered. It's just like a bummer. So how could we get better as humanity at doing war? And because I do, unfortunately, I think there is a need for this type of thing, because it's the wants. People want, so they want their stuffs. Everyone wants their stuffs so bad. And then you have entire nation states that wants their stuffs. And then you have like disagreements, man, over like what are those stuffs and what's fair and stuff. And it's just like, it gets so hectic. It gets so hectic. So I was thinking that war could be straight up an Olympic sport. And like there would have to be so much that would go into that, obviously, like all the parameters, because there would have to be some very serious parameters. Like the security team for the Olympic sport of war would have to be the most advanced and perfect security team. So it's a little bit, I guess it's, we get to a little bit of a paradox here, because if the security team is more powerful at war than the competitors that are competing, then what's to prevent the security team from just taking over the world? And I guess that's the big question, isn't it? But let's just imagine for this thought experiment that it's possible to have the best security team ever, so that you can create parameters for the Olympic sport of war. And you could have like different categories and stuff. There could be like firearms, there could be hand to hand, there could be like horses and arrows. You know, as you progress like through the technological scale, there'd be like an electronic warfare sport. So like it'd be like all the best hackers trying to hack each other from each nation. Oh man, can you imagine? Yeah, so it's just an idea that I had, that I believe that everything is possible, just like Kevin Garnett said after he won the national championship finally, because Kevin Garnett, he like wanted it so bad. He wanted it so bad for so long. And then he finally won the national championship and he's like, anything is possible. Because I think Kevin Garnett didn't think that he was gonna, okay, I'll say this. I think he may have had moments of doubt where he was like, you know what, I'm never gonna win a national championship. It's never gonna fucking happen for me. And then when he did, he was overwhelmed with emotion and he just let out that like very beautiful exclamation. And it's very inspiring for me to hear him scream that out. Like, because it helps me to believe too that I think that literally anything is possible. And that's a very beautiful mentality, because then it keeps your hope. You gotta have your hope, because if you don't have your hope, you get to be a depressed kitty. And I could talk to you about what it's like to be a depressed kitty, and it's no fun. I know a lot of people can relate to that. So you gotta keep your hope, so you gotta believe that anything is possible. So we're believing here that anything is possible. And just imagine how complex and also charismatic and also badass as fuck it would be if war was split into different categories of war, and then nations competed as an Olympic sport. And then you could then extrapolate that to when, like, nations are wanting their wants, because they're wanting little kittens. And then there's a disagreement over, like, we want this, but we want that. And then boom, and then sparks fly. Then you could, instead of slaughtering civilians, innocent civilians, which makes everybody sad, you could instead have, like, all right, let's do it. Let's have the Olympic war over here. And you have, like, the, you know, parameters. And yeah, it would be really, really cool. This would require a massive spiritual evolution of all humanity, because we'd have to put limit parameters around, like, the types of weapons. Because if weapons are just allowed to continue to grow through capitalism, like how well that stuff makes shit grow through capitalism. And I'm not over here trying to say that I subscribe to an ism or I don't subscribe to an ism, because I don't think we actually live under capitalism. We live under predatory capitalism, which is different from capitalism. There's capitalism and there's predatory capitalism. Predatory capitalism is really, really, really bad, because there's no limits on anything. And people just, if they can do it, they fucking do it. And that's really, really, really bad. So that's why we have to, like, evolve as a humanity and get better at everything. And so the reason for that is that so that innocent civilians are no longer slaughtered, because it makes all of us very sad and it traumatizes the whole vibe over here. And I'm trying to vibe out and you're trying to vibe out and we're all trying to vibe out, and it traumatizes the whole vibe when innocent civilians are slaughtered. So let's stop already. And thank you so much for listening. I love you all very much. Thank you for your continued support, the ups, the downs, the sideways, the every which ways. I also wanted to add as a little post note that I'm also a work in progress, and so I'm always trying to get better. And so I know that, like, certain things are not, like, top notch on my pod. Like, sometimes audio quality could be better and stuff like that. I need to just invest in a better microphone, but I will eventually. And but just the fact that the support continues through the ups and the downs, I really, really do appreciate that. And I also realize that sometimes when I feel edgy and I'm having a hard time, then I will be, like, maybe too edgy and maybe too, like, I don't want to alienate people. So I apologize, I guess, if I alienated anyone along the way, because I'm not trying to alienate anybody. And I'm also a work in progress, and I'm trying to get better, and I'm just realizing things as I go, which is kind of like the human experience. We go and then we realize things and we hopefully get better. And so let's all get better together, and let's elevate the human spirit, el humano espiritu. And I love you all. I'm going to finish this tidbit up, and then I'm going to vibe out and relax in my own special kitten way. And so until next time, much love. All right.
The house I live in, a puddle, a street, the grocer and the butcher, and the people that I meet, the children in the playground, the faces that I see, all races and religions, that's America to me.
What is up, love doves? Listen, it is 3:24 in the morning right now. 3:24 in the morning, and I am still going. I might have a lot of miles on my engine, but I'm a Toyota baby. I like to drive. I did so much today, I don't even know how it all happened. I did errands. I went paddleboarding. I even went to a quinceañera and danced norteño. How the fuck did I do all of this without collapsing in some sort of anxious pile of mush? The answer, love doves, party penguins, is magic. I've been drinking Magic Mind like a madman. My lovely sponsor, they've been sending me this Magic Mind, and I'm like a little baby bird in the nest when they go like, chirp, 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 and they want the mama bird to come give them the food, and then the Magic Mind comes, and I be drinking my Magic Mind. Now, I'm drinking it responsibly. I only have one or two Magic Minds a day, but I'll say this. The Magic Minds, when I'm like completely exhausted and about to have an anxiety attack, I slam that Magic Mind. And it helps. And that is the truth. I'm not even bullshitting you right now. So, job less Magic Mind. And you can get some Magic Mind too. And you can not only attain some Magic Mind, you can get a 20% discount because you are a loved of. You're a beloved Barbarian Noetics listener. You get a 20% discount at checkout. The links are in the description, but you go to magicmind.com/barbariannoetics20. Use that discount code, barbariannoetics20. Let the mama birds at Magic Mind send you the magical elixir. And then you just go chirp, 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 and you get that shit. And it helps. Because, I mean, I am recording a segment right now. It is almost 4 in the morning, and I have done so much today, it's insane. So, I'm just saying. What makes Magic Mind so fantastic? Oh Lord, let me count the ways. It's a mental performance shot. It's 100% safe. They believe that you gotta do things over time. They don't believe in quick fixes, which I appreciate. So you gotta like take the Magic Mind for like 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 days in a row. And then you really start to feel it. That is true. I think that's that bacopa they got in there. They got those cordyceps, baby. It's not a coffee replacement. Magic Mind is not trying to replace anyone's coffee. I love coffee. I work at a coffee shop. Magic Mind's not trying to replace anyone's coffee. They're trying to augment your experience of life right now. Magic Mind, they got time-released caffeine. I actually just learned this the other day, but I'll repeat it again. The caffeine doesn't actually give you energy. It only blocks the adenosine neuroreceptors in your brain. What the fuck? That's why you get that caffeine crash? Magic Mind don't do that. Magic Mind's like, yo, we got some ashwagandha. And I'm like, yo, I can use some ashwagandha. We can all use some ashwagandha up in this cut. Am I wrong? Listen, the doctors have validated it, okay? The doctors have validated it. So don't give me any of this garbage about doctors not validating stuff. The doctors have validated it. Over 200 scientific studies behind every ingredient. Mushrooms organically grown in California. They got that Cognizant City Choline, which you normally have to wait 2 years for, but they have it somehow, and then they give it to you like good mama birds, and you just go, I don't know why I just made that sound. That wasn't a bird sound at all. Uh-oh, maybe it is starting to show till this 4 in the morning. But listen, in all seriousness, their matcha is the highest possible grade. They use organic ceremonial grade matcha grown in Japan. They use that nano encapsulation technology that makes the ingredients more bioabsorbable. And they care about the houseless folks, which I really appreciate because I also really care about the houseless folks. Houseless folks need our help. It sucks to be houseless. I was houseless for a little while in Eugene, Oregon, and it was fucking wretched. So Magic Mind helping the houseless, they donate 5 cents for each bottle sold to mental health charities that help the US houseless communities. They're 100% carbon neutral. There's no risk whatsoever. They're so confident that you're gonna love that sweet, sweet ashwagandha and that boom, boom cordyceps that they're gonna refund you 100%, no questions asked, for 100 days after buying. So you don't even have to, it's a no risk. It is a, think of it as like an experiment. Try out that Magic Mind. They're now in Sprouts, which we all love up here in the valley, because good Lord, what would I do without that Sprouts? I mean, I also like my Natty Groceries too. Not trying to hate. Maybe Magic Mind could be in Natty Groceries someday. I don't know. They ship it internationally as well. So all my beloved international listeners, wherever you may be, And, you know, it's meant a lot to me over the years to build an international audience. And I'm, like, I feel very, like, happy and blessed that I have an international audience. Because I want to get out of, like, the echo chamber of, you know, I get it that people want things in the same place and they want stuff and you got to have that and all that. But I also want to know, like, how people do things in, like, Morocco and Papua New Guinea and Madagascar and Tanzania and, you know, I want to know how people do things in these places too, because it's interesting. I'm a curious kitten. And so they do ship internationally, so all my international listeners, pick up that magic mind. So once again, you can get 20% off because you're a loved of, and you just go magicmind.com/barbarianoetics20, use that code barbarianoetics20, and let yourself be blessed with the magical elixir that is Magic Mind. Oh, give me that magic mind. Yeah, 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 yeah. One love, everybody.
Take up some space. You're too far.
Chemistry.